Yeah, it's our first time here, and I like hearing stuff before we came here. I don't know.
Like, I know the Korean culture has really exploded kind of in the last year or two. So like, yeah. Korean beauty and K-pop have been huge things in Europe, and you know, I think that's all we've kind of seen of the place. But once we got here, Seoul is one of the biggest cities I've ever experienced. Like the roads are three times as big as New York. It's massive. So yeah, it's very different to what I expected.
The roads are amazing.
I had a Korean barbecue in New York like last year, and I just thought it was the most amazing food ever. And then when I had it last night, a proper Korean barbecue here, it just blew my mind.
Yeah.
It's just the way you eat, the way it comes and the way it's cooked in front of you, it's just, I love that. I love when it's kind of not just like you go into a restaurant and there's your plate and you eat what's on your plate. It's much more of a social thing.
Yeah.
So sure. hopefully, and there's Korean barbecue now in Ireland, so hopefully there's more and more.
There's a place called Hoth in Dublin that's absolutely amazing. You walk along the cliffs and the sea is there. You get that fresh Irish breeze and it's probably going to rain, which is all the time in Ireland.
You get a nice view of Dublin, like city and the bay and all that stuff. That's really nice. Dingle is another amazing place.
Yeah, west of Ireland. Kerry. There's so many pubs. I mean, everywhere you go, there's a pub, so go to all of them.
If you've got a week, go for a boat on the Shannon.
Yeah.
We've only done recently, and it's one of the best things. You just cruise down, you know, take it really slow, and just kind of, you stop off at every 3 pubs. It's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, there's so much, like, over the years. I mean, one that we always remember is losing Vinny.
Yeah, we got left at a truck stop in America, which was kind of fun, kind of not fun, because it was in the middle of America and it all looks the same.
And he had no phone signal.
Yeah, and I couldn't call anybody.
And it took us a half an hour before we realised that he wasn't on the bus.
Yeah.
Our tour manager was like, "Are you missing something?" And I straight away reached for my passport. I was like, "No, I got it. Your drummer? The drummer is gone."
Yeah.
We found him and
so I got left in New York.
Yeah, left in New York.
It was great, actually.
Jay lost his passport in the right place. He lost it in New York, and then he just got to stay in New York for a week and have a holiday. So.
We're pretty uneventful these days. We try not to lose each other.
Yeah.
He died.
Jesus!
No, that's not true. What I kind of liked about it is it's very unique, but it's also like you can't tell if he's falling or if he's flying or if he's on the ground or whatever, you know? So it's kind of cool.
Yeah.
Depends on how you look at
it. Yeah, but we got him to do like all the single artwork as well for all the singles, so it's kind of nice just having like a solid theme running through everything. But the one that we chose for Positive, and that just kind of, it always kind of stood out as one that we definitely wanted to use. And then, yeah, it was just kind of cool coming up with different colour combinations, you know. But yeah, really good.
Brother, I'd say.
Real help all over.
Fire, it's really great song to play live. And yeah, it was the first single off the album, so...
Angel?
Yeah.
I think most of our songs are their personal experiences, so it's hard to fake that, so it comes across in the recordings of the songs and the writing of the songs, and I think a lot of our fans can relate to that, which is awesome. And when they do actually relate to it, but when a fan comes up with his own God, like, totally, I went through this situation, it's like exactly what the song is about. It's amazing. But that happens very rarely. It's one of the best things about playing music and being songwriters, when we hear fans coming up and saying that music has touched them and helped them or made them a little bit happier or made their lives a little bit easier. And it just makes everything more fun for us. And it just inspires us to keep writing and keep touring and keep playing music.
I think it was one of the first shows to sell out, like, and it sold out really quickly as well. which is amazing for us because it's our first time being here. So I think that means that like people are going to be really into the show. This is going to fall into like chaos now. Oh no, hold on. Yeah, it's going to be great. I think like
the family and I talk with them.
Yeah.
I thought it was going to descend into chaos.
I thought it was going to descend into chaos.
Don't make me slap you.
Shouldn't it, like Kathy's on the table?
Yeah, should have taken them away.
Like. Expect judicious use of these throughout the show.
Yeah.
Bought a ticket for an aeroplane.
Hi. Hey, how do you say thank you?
Hey, Korea. We just want to say thank you so much.
You're a bit more energetic.
Energetic.
You can't stop thinking about gin and tonic.
Energetic. God damn it, I just want a gin.
Be more gin and tonic.
Okay. Be more gin and tonic.
Okay.
Hey, Korea, Kamala here. We just want to say thanks so much for making the show sell out so early.
Kamala, we love you guys and we are taken aback by your support and we can't wait to come back. And you guys are amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you guys so much.